mama, I'm in fear for my life from the long arm of the law. Lawman is putting an end to my running, and I'm so far from my home. Oh, mama, I can hear you a-crying, you're so scared and all alone. Hangman is coming down from the gallows, and I don't have very long.
After we just finished it against Cleveland, we go to our worst territory in the West Coast.
Yeah. Okay, guys, this is fucking funny. We are not cutting this out. So, we were doing a test with the audio to make sure everything's working and shit. Hopefully it is, because we're actually going to make this video. We're not cutting nothing out. We were trying to test out the audio, make sure everything's working and everything. I accidentally pushed record on the video format thing that we're recording on right now. And Bobby just freestyled and started with making the vid.
Screw it. Fuck it.
Yeah, man. Arizona Cardinals. What week is this? I've lost 13. Track. 14?
14.
I think 15. It's 14. I think it's week like 14. I think it's week. But nonetheless, man, it's the Arizona Cardinals. They are, what, 3-8-1, I believe. So, yeah. I think we all know what type of game could be potentially expected. I don't know. It depends on how you look at it. It depends how the Steelers honestly look at it, man. Well, first of all, Mike Tomlin has confirmed that Duck Hodges will be getting the start again, thankfully. I think that's the right call. I think that's the right move. The entire offense just gelled well with Duck in as the quarterback. Duck looked better in as quarterback than Mason has the past two games that Mason has played.
Right.
And, you know, I think Duck's a little bit more risky, a little bit more aggressive. That's kind of what the offense kind of needs, man. And it really sparked the offense a lot more than what we've seen with Mason, unfortunately.
Right,
so,
and quite frankly, it's the right decision to make.
Yeah. And, you know, he also mentioned, Mike Tomlin has mentioned that there isn't as much clarity or there isn't any more clarity in terms of injury with Juju Smith-Schuster and James Conner. He said that they're both questionable for this week, and Conner has a better chance of practicing than Juju does. So that kind of sucks. Now, depending on how you look at it, you know, it's a good thing because they'll more likely be healthy for the Bills game next Sunday night, which is good. Obviously, we all know the Bills, they're a real good team right now. They're in the playoff rankings right now, and
right,
we all know their defense. So it's a good thing that they might be healthy and they might be back for next week's Sunday night game. But, again, depending on how you look at this week's Cardinals game, man, and Arizona, this could be a potential trap game. I mean, look at Arizona Cardinals. They're 3-8-1. They are a developing team right now. And it's in the West Coast.
Yeah. I said this about the Arizona Cardinals. I don't see them as a terrible team. I see them more as a developing team. And that started when they drafted Kyler Murray first overall
this past offseason. Of
course. In the draft.
And, yeah, you know, just looking at the Cardinals, they clearly seem like a developing team. But it looks like when it comes to those teams and the Steelers, we always fall into the trap. It's always one of those Tomlin specials that what people like to call it. It's always a trap game. And, I don't know, it depends on how you look at it, man. Because me personally, I don't think the Cardinals are that bad of a team. They're really lacked because of their terrible defense and, you know, the offensive line has hurt Kyler Murray and shit. So, and that's where our defense has to take advantage and everything, which we'll get into eventually. But Arizona Cardinals, man. Of course, like you said, they drafted Kyler Murray number 1 overall. Ever since, they have been pretty much developing for the potential future. They got Cliff Kingsbury as their head coach who could potentially turn their team around. Mm-hmm. And we've seen some signs of that, especially on the offensive side of the ball for the Cardinals. Kyler Murray, I'm not going to lie, I wasn't high, if you know where I'm going with. I wasn't high on Kyler Murray. You see what I did there?
I believe.
Because
I think
he's fucking short and shit.
Yeah,
I wasn't exactly high on Kyler Murray because it had nothing to do with his height or anything. It's just I didn't see him as a solid quarterback. I didn't see him as, I didn't even see him as a first round pick, to be completely real. But he has kind of made me eat my words. He's had a pretty solid rookie season. He's pretty much he's shown that he could be the potential future for the Cardinals at quarterback, honestly.
Right. I mean, it's just, I pretty much felt the same way about Kyler Murray. I did see him as a first-round pick, but not first overall.
Right.
But I only saw that because the Cardinals had the first overall. I didn't really see him fitting the Cardinals system whatsoever.
Right.
But just like you said, he's done a lot better than I expected. Absolutely. He's actually played very well. That offense is actually driving down for the most part this season. He's connecting with Fitzgerald. He's pretty much doing what he can as a rookie.
Yeah. Now, of course, he is making mistakes. He has some flaws. Of course, every rookie does. And he's had a solid rookie season, but the his offensive line is kind of, you know, hurt him a lot with his production and his mistakes. And again, that's where our defense had to capitalize and force Kyler Murray to do the exact same thing. And that's where our defense and offense has to take advantage. Because
right. The
Cardinals, their offense, you know, Larry Fitzgerald, one of the greatest wide receivers of all time. Me personally, you guys may call me crazy or whatever. And yes, Jerry Rice is arguably better. Terrell Owens is arguably better. And Randy Moss is arguably better. But I would make a solid case for Larry Fitzgerald to be the greatest wide receiver of all time. That dude is just a monster.
He's a monster. He's a baller. I don't care if he's a client. He's a beast. He is uncoverable. Whatever you throw at him, he's going to catch it.
Yeah,
he's probably got easily probably the best hands in NFL history.
Exactly.
Probably.
And he's still putting up pretty decent numbers for his age, man. And to me, it doesn't look like he's slowing down. He's not putting up stats he did 10 years ago and shit, but he's still a pretty productive guy for that young offense and for a young quarterback like Kyler Murray, man. Of course, Christian Kirk's their number two. Andy Isabella is a scary, speedy, deep threat. Of course, they have they have the potential to have a hell of a fucking rushing game in the offense with Chase Edmonds, David Johnson, Kenyon Drake, who they just traded for. And that's been pretty much a new sign of life for him since coming to Arizona. David Johnson, I don't know where the hell he fell off. Like, I remember at one point he was being called as the best running back in the league, or at least top three.
He was in discussion with it back in the day when it was just Elliott and Bell up there.
Yeah. It's like
guys like that.
And where he just fell off completely. He hasn't rebounded. He completely has the potential to be the best running back in the league. He's so versatile. He's so explosive, but injuries has hurt him. He's fell off the fucking ship and shit. It's just, he has just fell off so much since that year, since that 2015 year. It's insane. And, of course, Chase Edmonds, you know, he has the potential to be nice backup. Edmonds.
Edmonds.
Edmonds?
It's Edmonds.
It doesn't matter, man. It's pretty much the same thing. There's only an O replaced with the U and shit. Don't matter with me. But
You get what we're saying.
Yeah, he has the potential to be a solid backup, but he hasn't really done much since that one game where he had three touchdowns and he's been out ever since. So
right. They
had the potential to be there. It's just their offense has been plagued with terrible offensive line and injuries. Especially in the rushing game.
Right,
so,
and their defense is
statistically one of the worst in the league right now. It's just horrendous.
Yeah, their defense is awful.
Now, they have players on the defense side of the ball that really speak out to you. Of course, the old-timer, the ageless wonder, Terrell Suggs. We all know where he came from in Baltimore. We all know his history with Pittsburgh and Ben and shit. So,
and you obviously got the guy beside him and Chandler Jones, one of the best edge rushers in the league.
One of the most underrated, absolutely.
You got obviously Patrick Peterson, a shutdown corner. You got an up-and-rising safety in Buda Baker. And Jordan Hicks, who's having a career year in Arizona.
Yeah, and let's not forget the guy opposite of Patrick Peterson since they got rid of, who was it, Tremaine Brock?
I believe so.
Coming from Byron Murphy. He was a dude that we were incredibly high on coming out of Washington. We had him mocked in so many of our drafts, our mock drafts and shit, this past April and everything, this past draft season, in the first round specifically. So we're very high on Byron Murphy, and he has the potential to be a lockdown guy opposite Patrick Peterson or whatever. So they have players that stick out to you, but they just give up a lot of splash plays. They give up a lot of big plays. They give up a lot of points and a lot of yardage. And with this offense, although Juju and Connor still might be out this week and Hodges might have to deal with weapons he had last week, you know, this offense got to capitalize. They got to take advantage. They got to score. They got to ball, you know, like they did last week against the Browns, man. James Washington's going to have his work cut out for him with Patrick Peterson. So Deontay Johnson, Deion Kane, and Vance McDonald definitely got to step up, as well as Tevin Jones and everyone, and especially in the rushing game. Benny Snell, Jalen Samuels got to step up in that aspect too. So everyone on the offense has to step up here, with Juju and Connor still potentially out and everything. So yeah,
the Cardinals, their defense is awful. But they got some players that can pretty much get the job done for the most part.
Absolutely.
So, just like you said, the offense has to make plays. They have to get down the field. They have to get into the end zone. They got to help us win this game.
Yeah, absolutely. Duck has to work a little bit more on his composure and his comfortability in the pocket and everything. You know, like you said, the two edge rushers with Suggs and Jones, you know. The offensive line is going to have their work cut for him. Thankfully, Marquise Pouncey will be back in this one, so that should strengthen up the offensive line a little bit more. Although Finney did a phenomenal job filling in for Pouncey during his two-game suspension. You know, Duck got to make the right throws, right calls and everything.
Right decision-making in general.
Absolutely. Like we said, everyone just got to step up. James Washington, Deontay Johnson, Deion Kane. I would more so focus on the rushing game here. Even if Connor's back, I'd still split reps with him and Snell, mostly running the ball, get the ground game going, smooth out the offense a little bit, drain the clock and everything. Yeah. So definitely help the offense out. Definitely help Duck out with the rushing game a little bit more. As for the defense, man, guys, just continue with the fucking doing, man. Force Kyler Murray to make mistakes. Take advantage of that offensive line. Bud Dupree, T.J. Watt, Cameron Hayward, Javon Hargrave, Alu Alu, you guys got to be key here like you were last week. Pass rush, continue to do what you're doing, as well as this entire defense, secondary to front seven. Try to shut down the rushing game as much as you can. Secondary, just do what the hell you're doing, man. You guys are doing a phenomenal job. Just absolutely. Keep it up. Don't slow down. Don't keep that foot off the pedal. Don't release any fucking pressure, man. Just keep the gas going, man. Just
keep doing what you're doing.
Exactly.
Turnovers, pass rush. Be consistent. Do what you're doing.
Absolutely. You know, we're facing a pretty young offense here, so this defense hopefully can make plays. And you know, speaking of the young offense, you know, they are more prone to make mistakes. So defense got to take advantage of that. And, of course, offense got to take of what our defense gives us and shit. So
right.
Now, again, speaking of all that, it does sound like a trap game. It does sound like the usual Steelers trap game, you know, where we go into a terrible team's stadium and just flop, you know.
Yeah, especially when the Steelers usually have momentum on their side. They have, like, big momentum right now.
Yeah,
like they usually do. But then when they face a terrible team, it just goes right down the toilet.
Exactly. You know,
especially if it's an away game.
Absolutely. Because it's happened many times before, man. It's happened many times in the past. It's happened earlier this season. So hopefully that's not the case. Hopefully it's a different story this time around. Hopefully we go in Arizona and get the win and everything. Get three straight. Continue that or keep that six seed spot, man, and continue off the AFC climber and everything. And keep the win streak going and just all that good shit, man. So hopefully we get this dub against Arizona. I would not underestimate them whatsoever. They are a pretty solid young team that are in development. Give them a few years, they could be a very solid potential playoff contender and everything. They could potentially give the Niners a run for the money in terms of division as well as the Seahawks. So I'm not going to sleep on the Cardinals in this one, nor will I sleep on them in the future. So just be careful in this one. Against Arizona, you're going away at Arizona, around the West Coast and everything, where, of course, the Steelers don't really pan well too much. Hopefully, Steelers Nation invades Arizona like they have much so often in the West Coast before and everything. So hopefully we see a lot of Steelers Nation in Arizona and everything continue to rock the entire black and gold and everything and just around the world and shit. So continue to do what you guys are doing, man, as well for this team. Just keep it up, you know. As well as the defense. Defense, I think, has to be key here because with Juju and Connor out, I like how our offense is starting to spark and everything, but I still don't necessarily trust him in terms of consistency. So I don't know what to expect here, but hopefully we get the dub in Arizona. Let's get the win, guys. Let's advance to 3 straight and everything. Let's advance to 8-5. Keep that 6-seed spot. Get some more momentum heading into the Bills Sunday night football game next week and shit. So let's see what we can do, man. Let us know your guys' thoughts down below, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Here we go, Steelers.
Like, comment, subscribe. We'll see you later.
Peace!